morning, guys. Look at that sky. It's 8:20 in the morning and it's still this dark. And I'm being very quiet because everyone else in the house is still sleeping. I've got really massive jet lag. But how pretty is that? Oh, man. All right, look at that. So here's one of them traditional phone booths of the UK. It says their email, text, and phone, and I don't... Oh, there's a little, like a little computer, is it? I don't know. Does it still work? I don't know if it still works. Here we've got the Loch Ness Inn. If you guys didn't know, we are actually about 10 minutes away from the famous Loch Ness. If you've ever heard of the Loch Ness Monster, we're gonna try and find him today. That's where Duncan and I are walking. We're walking towards Loch Ness. Look at those beautiful hills. There's a graveyard over here. It's hills. And then sort of a little ranch with a little horsey.
Hi, horsey.
Sorry, I was going to bite me. This here used to be the old school house where Duncan went for primary school.
Secondary school.
There you go. Yeah, and his story was that he used to ride the bike, ride behind the bike of his brother, and his brother won't even slow down to let him off. Really cool. Here we go. Keep on walking. It's drizzling a little bit, and you can see the leaves have already fallen, and the season has really changed already. Well, we didn't get all the way to Loch Ness because where there used to be a path, now water flows. So there was no way for us to cross it. So we just headed back and just decided we'll take a walk around the old neighborhood. This one here used to be where Duncan would have to go to do PE or physical ed. And that over there, where it says Drum Takeaway, is a fish and chip shop where Duncan had his first job. He used to be the one frying the fish and the chips for takeaway. So, yeah, pretty cool. And now he's an executive chef for a 5-star hotel. Can you imagine? So we're back at the house and we've got a full Scottish breakfast here. Yummy. What is that?
Sausage.
We've come to the shopping center to get some Christmas gifts for Duncan's family, and I can't think of anything to get them.
This is called the Victorian Market. So that's the town for you. And you will notice that there aren't very many Asians around. I'm probably the only one here right now. I haven't seen any other ones. Here's a Scottish souvenir shop for you. This is what they call the High Street, where you get a lot of the shops that are a little bit more affordable. Just look. The one in the blue is Duncan's mum. Right down there is where Marks and Spencer is and the mall that we were in earlier. And right down here is the rest of the High Street. And at the very end you'll see that the castle is being renovated and restored to its former glory. That's the castle there behind being renovated. Okay, so I went to Primark and I got a few things there. A set of 3 pairs of boot socks for £3. These are really nice and comfortable and soft. 2 sets of pajamas for £8. So this one has got like little hearts on them. £8 is the top with the bottom. And I am in the size medium. And then the other one is more of a plaid. Yeah, it's not properly done right now because I tried it on. And I found these. They're £2 each, and these are their metal matte liquid lipsticks. This one's more like a rose gold topper. And this one's more of a magenta red with sort of like holographic purple on them. I don't know if there's a name on them. Just says, oh, this one's called Kylie right there. And this one's called Queen. We also went to a shop. I forget what it's called, but they had this. This is the Papermate Ink Joy. I hear a lot of things about this from other planners. There's 25 InkJoy 300RT in here, and it's only $6.99. Originally, this was supposed to be $19.99, but if you buy anything in the store, you get it for £6.99. And Duncan bought a book by Jamie Oliver, or no, by Gordon Ramsay, it was £6. And so I got this for $6.99, and there's like 25 of these. I don't need any more pens, but what can you do? Okay, and then the last place that we went to was called B&M, which is a bargain place. And I got 2 bonnets here. One is more of a blush shade, and the other one's more of a champagne. As well as this W7 in the Nude Natural Nudes eye color palette. There's 12 eyeshadows in here, and this was supposed to be $8, but it came to $4.99. By the way, I forgot to say, this 2 is $3.99 for this 2, what is it called? Ladies Metallic Hats. And this one, I was very interested in this because I've seen a lot of reviews about this, comparing this to the Urban Decay Naked 3 palette. Now, I'm not sure if the arrangement of the shades are similar, but and this is not giving it justice because I am under yellow lights, but this ones are really rosy. I'll probably try and insert a photo of this one with better lighting tomorrow morning. So there you have it. That's my shopping haul for today. I still intend to go to a Superdrug and find that dupe for the Kat Von D eyeshadow palette and the Too Faced chocolate bar palette.